Hi everybody, Scott Card here today with another quick Proteus tip. Today I'd like to talk to you about how to create a pad so that you could attach something like this TO220 and be able to get thermal bonding right to your circuit board without the solder mask getting in the way. All right. My schematic here, as you can see, there's not a whole lot. And all we're really interested in looking at is a U1. So let's dive in here and have a quick peek at it. I've already created a PCB layout, and I'm just going to pull in my U1 here real quick. And you can see that it is just a TO220, but it's laid on its side. It's quite a nice little package. And there's a few things that we're going to do. The first thing is we'll get rid of that. And I'm going to create a heatsink pad, if you would. So I'm going to go here to zone mode. And I'm going to grab, say here we'll put it. I'll call that good enough. And we want to put it on a net. And the net that I've chosen is VO for V out. And I'll relieve the pins here. Why not? And so if you're wondering where to get that net, basically just add a wire label. Okay, so we're going to place a wire label. And in this case, I called it VO. You could call VN. You could call adjust. Doesn't really matter. But when we go back to our PCB here, one of the things that you can do is to make sure that you do define it as VO. And I'm going to create a second one now and follow the same pattern. It doesn't have to be. As a matter of fact, I could make it larger. And we'll put it on the bottom. And I will also connect it to VO. And I'll say OK. And we'll make it bigger on the other axes as well. And so that's fantastic. And then the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to right click and I'm going to put in some via stitching. And I'm going to put in 0.3 millimeter because that's what my board house likes. And why don't I make the spacing say 50 thousandths of an inch and keep it 25 thou from the edges. And I'll say, okay. And you'll see that it does do a nice job of stippling these two together. The downside is when we take a look at our 3D image, we wouldn't be able to get very good thermal transfer because we have this solder mask getting in the way. And so what we're going to do is we're going to go in and we're going to create a 2D graphic. And this graphic is going to be on the top resist. And I will make it that big because I'm not taking the time to actually figure out what it needs to be. Obviously, you are going to take a look at the data sheet and make it the right size. But for today, that's okay. We're then going to highlight it. We're going to right click. We're going to edit the properties. We're going to go to our graphic style. And we're going to make it solid. Say this graphic only. Now when we go to our 3D layout, you'll see that it is nicely cleared so that we can actually get some thermal paste in there if we want, or at least bolt the TO220 directly to it. And we have a large pad to dissipate heat off the backside. All right. Hopefully this is helpful. If it is, please give me a thumbs up, comment away, subscribe if you'd like to be made aware when I make more videos like this. If you didn't like it, please comment down below. Thumbs down is okay as well. I'd love to hear from you. All right. As always, thanks and have yourself a great day. Bye now.